This is the one locker room for the boys and girls swim team and water polo. That's it. There currently are not enough lockers for all team members, so they share two or three in the locker, and everything else goes on the pool deck. This is the original locker room from 1957.
It's not accessible either.
And it's not ADA compliant. There's currently no diving because the pool is not deep enough. It's only 10 feet deep. So all diving is canceled.
A short history on it. Obviously, we had you walk through the locker room and I heard a few people talk about it. That is our unisex locker room. So that is our locker room for the girls' season. And that is our locker room for the boys' season. So the girls' season, so about 82 girls. If you looked at the numbering, there's 88 lockers in there. That is also our locker room for PE classes. So I cannot give them individual locker rooms. I triple them up. That's our locker room for the visitors. During the boys' season, I still have females going in there for PE classes, but the boys will go in and you'll see a little red sign on the wall that says boys' locker room from these hours of the day. So we're watching the hours of the day, making sure. And so we're trying to determine what's going on. Why do you do something like that? When you build a pool like this, you build it before Title IX. You build it when there was only a boys team to think about. So during that time, you build a 6-lane pool, 10 foot deep. This is state of the art, built in 1958. And then over the 60 year span of this pool, we've had air quality issues as you're starting to sense and feel. So we're working up our original Dectron. So our original air handler is the 1958 air handler, and we keep trying to patchwork it, try and make it work. This year was another patchwork. You're sensing the how that is, you know. So coaches were on here a good 4 or 5 hours of the day before a meet, whatever it might be. Swimmers are in here, and that air quality. We're no longer allowed to use our diving boards. The diving boards fell short of a 1980s law that said that you cannot dive into 10 feet of water. So we were grandfathered in, but then when they recalculated on a audit, they determined that that ledge right here was just impossible for us to do so. So we've looked at lots of options as to how to do this. As a former swimmer and a community member, I've looked at this years and years, and back in the 90s, we talked about trying to fix it, make it bigger, because our program has grown so much. When I swam here in the 90s, we were at 40 athletes per, and now we're trying to run 80, 75 for boys, 82 for girls. And without diving, it makes it even more difficult, because now we're sending our athletes to opposing teams to try and do so in practice. Trying to think what else I can tell you.
We'll answer questions if you have any questions about the pool.
How do you play water polo?
That is a great question. So, question was, how do you do water polo in here?
Two of our sports, girls and boys water polo, you technically are not allowed to touch the bottom of the pool. If you use the pool as an aid, then it is a turnover for the opposing team. I don't even know how to put that as a reference to a different sport, but our pool is 3.5 feet deep over there, all the way to 5 feet by that black line. So there's always a chance that kids are getting an advantage, and it's just not a legitimate way for them to train or learn how to do it. So the sport itself requires at least usually 2 meters just for them to have a gentle place for them to practice and train. So they do all of their training in this area, and you're putting about 40 kids in this spot. Okay, so they do their entire practice in this spot, trying to do a varsity and JV practice in this area right here. Just because when they go to an opposing team, they're at a distinct disadvantage because they've trained their whole life standing on the bottom and there's no bottom. So we have a club program. The question was who uses the pool other than the swimming and the water polo teams. We used to run a guard system. We used to do lessons program out of here. Our programming times, we start at doors open at 5:15. Kids hit the water at 5:45. We're done swimming at usually 7:30. And then we start again at 3:15, 3:10.
Well, we have PE classes during the day.
He was just asking about outside, I thought. Were you talking about?
Both.
So then during the day, we have lifeguard and aquatics classes. We have adaptive PE in here. We have, it's FITS 3, but I think they just changed the name of it. They come in for 2 units. We have FITS 1 that's gonna come in next year. Science classes, if you use it for their, you know, different classroom experiments. They do a nice little build your own boat out of cardboard type stuff. Then we use it from 3 until 10:15 with our between high school program, whether it be swimming or polo, and then our HSC swim program, which is just short of 200 kids. Yes, ma'am. We have to either, we have like a negotiation with either Downers Grove North or LT in order to use their diving facilities, because the only way that we're allowed to practice here with diving is if we get all of our competitors to, or like our actual participants on our team, to sign a waiver saying they are aware that the pool is too shallow and that they're gonna try and use the diving boards as under their own, like,
risk.
We're not allowed to practice with other teams, so we have to work around their time slot, so we're not allowed to go during their practice times. So that's illegal in the IHSA, so we have to find the time to practice outside of their practice times. So, are you talking the red or the blues? Are you talking the red or the blues? The blues is what we're not allowed to do. The red ones installed currently under the current law is 4.5 feet, which would be 4 feet 6 inches, but we get, that will change soon. That's gonna go to 2 meters in probably the next 5 years. So the trend is the following, that what was happening for the swimmers is they were going, the sport has changed, world records are breaking all over the place, and that's because most of the sport is done underwater. So they're encouraging swimmers to dive as deep as they can to try and go as far as they can. Current law says 4 feet 6 inches. If we were to dive into that, we would send more and more kids to the hospital and we'd be dealing with what we already are, which is a lot of neck breaking. So this is 10 feet where we stand. So if you see it right under me, I think it says 10 feet. The blue diving boards are what we're not allowed to use. That was new when we installed it. We installed one of those new before we heard about that restriction, that same year, within months.
With a 10-lane, 40-yard stretch pool, how much more programming will you get?
For what we're proposing and what, you know, the, what we think that the community needs, we would be allowed to have community swim time where we could open up the doors and let the community come in and swim. We'd have to find time to be able to guard that. We would be allowed to bring in a whole lessons program again. We'd be allowed to bring in for the classrooms. We could bring in a unit for every single grade where they would come in here and be able to be in the class. Adaptive could be in the water at any time that they want instead of a 2 or 3 week restriction during when we can move into the classroom for the different PE classes. And then you, to run a high school swim meet or a water polo match, that's in that 3.5-4 hour range. So everyone's at the same event. If the facility was built to the size of the program, you would take it down to that comparable 2 to 2.5 hour event, which most programs run.
Thank you, Coach Barber, we appreciate it.
Everybody needs to go back to the auditorium.
Courtney, if you can lead us out, we're gonna head down to count for the social work, room 107. We're gonna head down to our student service center, and I'll dress us in the counseling office down there when we get down.
You can
can see that all the photos on the walls have faded. And it's not because of sunlight, it's because of the chlorine in the pool. The newer photos are over here, interspersed with some of the older ones, newer. And you can't even tell who some of the people are in the photos because they've faded so badly due to the chlorine and the air quality in the pool. And it's currently nobody swimming in the pool, and it's probably close to 85, 90 degrees in here.